Alright, I'm going to E-Foil in the Exuma, departing from Pilo Night, and going to Key West to pick up my friends.
Pilo Night traffic, King Air Whiskey Sierra taking off runway 4.
And here we go. Torque at 2000, the speed is alive. Rotation at 97. VR. Positive rate, landing gear up. Flaps up. Autopilot on.
Tampa departure, King Air 14, Whiskey Sierra 1200, climbing 2000, heading
090. King Air 14, Whiskey Sierra, Tampa departure, good morning, ident, climb and maintain 7000.
Flight is kind of short, less than an hour. Weather is not that great. But luckily, I picked a level that is just between two layers, so it's perfect. The plane is amazing. It's going to fly at 300 knots pretty much anywhere between level 250 and level 320. I went once to 350 just for better wind. And it will climb fine, close to 1,000 feet all the way to the top. Just an extraordinary machine. Yeah. I went to flight safety to train, which is a great school, and you train on the full motion simulator for 2 weeks with the ground school. It was a little bit of a learning curve.
So I told my wife that we had a guy coming in my class who was
general aviation a pilot owner,
and she said, "Oh my gosh, how's that going?" I said, "Well, he's the real deal, because when you come here, you are going to get a beat down, and people, you are going to just, it is hard, hard, hard."
So you've been going to simulator for 20 years.
Over 20 years.
And it still
beats you up. It still beats you down. We call it a beat down. It totally stresses me out to come here and get a beat down.
It was a great experience. You get to do all the failure, then you come out with your ticket. When we bought the plane, it was equipped with a ProLine 21, which is kind of an antiquated system. And
I mean, JetBlue 1422,
the airplane with a full G1000 and it's extraordinary. So we just enter some clouds, and of course, as usual, you pick up a little bit of ice. When you fly in the flight level, you're always around that temperature, and right now we're at minus 14 Celsius, so maybe I'll run the boots. Okay, I've just been cleared for the visual approach. I'm going to refuel in Key West, pick up my three friends, and up we go. We're going to fly to Congo Town in Andros to clear custom with the Bahamian government and COVID, and that's about 55 minute flight, and then from there we'll have another little island hop, 15 minute flight to Stenio Cay, our final destination.
King Air 14 Whiskey Sierra, Key West Tower, report turning final, runway 9, or wind 100 at 9.
Landing gear down, we have three greens, and we run full flaps, lights on. About 100 and between 140 and 120 on final, and then the VREF is 102 at my weight.
500. Minimums.
Now at 120, I can start to reduce speed to reach threshold at 100 of VREF. Alright, that's the equipment they want to put on board. I don't think we're going to put all that stuff. It's kind of crazy.
Alright, ready to go.
Here we go.
Let's do it.
E-foil number one.
Chris, how long are we in the air?
Yeah, buddy.
We just cleared custom in Congo Town. We're going for a little 15 minute flight to Stenio Cay.
Go ahead.
collecting rocks. Christoph, the badass pilot here.
Real deal.
Real deal.
E-foil delivery. Here it comes.
Let's go.
Yeah!
Got a pig here.
There's no reason to take an unwilling pig on an E-foil.
Lake, the Tarzan of the sea.
The Tarzan of the sea.
I like that.
Oh yeah.
And our main goal for today is to get Christoph flying on
E-foiling,
the foil.
Yeah.
And I'm very excited to learn how to E-foil for the first time with the legendary Blake, the best teacher you can find around. And let's go for it.
Yalla.
Guys, I wanted to introduce you to my new Cirrus SR22 G6 2019. I always wanted to have a Cirrus at one point. It's a great, the best single engine ever built, super secure. The electronic on board is amazing. The G1000 NXI without autopilot is a rock solid for single IFR pilot. But anyway, today I'm going for a little hamburger in Marathon. Flight should be around an hour and 15 minutes, maybe 120. And I'm going to climb at 15,000. All right, so rotation at 77, up to 600 feet. We'll land on the channel on the left side. 600 feet, we have the cap. Well, deploy the parachute, and at 2,000 feet, we'll see if we can come back to the airport. We have full power. And speed is alive. Rotate. 90, flaps up. At 200 feet, the yaw damper will turn on automatically. Okay, we have the yaw damper. And I'm going to engage the autopilot and heading mode.
Planet traffic suggests.
Now the plane is going to turn to my heading of 130.
At 2,000 feet for right, traffic runway 13.
600.
At 4,000.
Tampa departure, Cirrus 282 Alpha Tango Hilo.
Cirrus 282 Alpha Tango Tampa, first day your position and request.
Yeah, we're about 5 miles south east of Piro Knight, 1,100 feet, direct. Sabi, we have IFR to Marathon.
November 2 Alpha Tango, you are cleared to the Marathon Airport via continued present heading, climb and maintain 1,600, expect 15,000 within 10 minutes, the Tampa altimeter 3003.
Alright, we're on our way, clear from 4,000 to 12,000. We are clear to our cruising altitude, and I'm going to turn the oxygen on. This plane is very well built. And they thought about everything. the software on the G1000 and XI perspective is telling you everything you need to. It's gonna ask for pitot heat and ask for oxygen and let you know everything you need to do. It's super well integrated.
Climbing to level 340.
As you can see, you know, I'm averaging about 1,000 feet per minute, which is pretty good with the turbo. And at 15,000, I should have about 175 knots. Once reached altitude, that's where you do the big extra down.
2141, we're level 10,000.
To fly lean off peak. So they have that little agenda line that's very helpful. I'm going to push the manifold back to 30.5. And now what I want to do is I control the TIT by pushing the mixture forward, which increased my power, and I stay in the vicinity of 1600. The red line for TIT is close to 1800, and now my fuel flow is at 16.5. My indicated airspeed is 138. But my true airspeed is 181, which is where we want to be. Now, if you go into the trip planning and you look at the efficiency, I'm actually doing almost 11 miles per gallon, which is as good as a truck. As I was saying, the only drawback with this is really the pressurization. You know, when you fly pressurized, you don't have to deal with oxygen and cannulas and checking your oximeter. When I'm by myself, it's fine, it's easy. I got that little boom. When I travel with passengers, it's complicated. You have wires all over the place. Turbo gives you much more options of altitude depending on the weather mostly and wind. I always use my four flight on my iPad for the approach plate. A great system, it's easier than the approach plate on the G1000. But when I fly over the water, I have the life raft in the back ready to be picked up, and of course I have life jacket. I also have a e-bird that I attach to my belt. My way back from a beautiful little booper sandwich in Marathon. Pit on night traffic, Sirius 2 Alpha Tango, 4 miles inbound from the southeast, landing runway 4. Landing lights are on. Put the mixture full reach, flaps, fuel pumps. Here we go. Surprisingly, it turned out to be a rainy day after all. 140. I have the flaps on and I'm going to disconnect the autopilot. Pedo night traffic, Sirius 2 Alpha Tango, right base, runway 4, Pedo. Use the speed to 110.
Stop, clear runway 4, Pedo night.
On the top of the white arc, and then I'll put the second degree of flaps. There is no traffic in the pattern anymore. Go full flaps.
Traffic and has retail 1 mile final runway 31 full stop center.
It's a pretty easy plane to land again. Try my last turn around 90. Flaps up, landing lights. That was a beautiful day. Now you got to see this beautiful machine.
For me, the Sirius is the best piston single engine airplane on the market.
Parachute technology is a game changer in safety and has already saved hundreds of lives over more than 120 deployments. Now that the technology exists, I don't think I would buy a single engine without a parachute.